How y'all doing tonight? My name, Oklahoma. I learned to pronounce that correctly. The good side of that is, well, really there is no good side, because, you know, the bad side to that is, every time I come down here, I usually have a different female, because I'm like, you want to go to Miami? She's like, yeah! Till she find out where the hell we going. For real, y'all laughing. I got a group of young lady with me right now. She's like, I don't see no palm trees. It ain't none. I'm playing. I'm joking. I love it where I am. Y'all give it up for Billy getting married, man. Give it up for that shit. Now, I'm going to let everybody clap, because he married me to get some real love. Yeah. His wife has to love him for him. Did y'all see Billy? Shit. Feel like he got 9 months. No, boy, we having a little boy, a little girl, Billy. Every time I see, she made me believe in real love again. Hell. I'm a black guy with a little dick, so I'm definitely looking for real love. She's going to have to love me for me. I got a Tic Tac. I don't know what happened. I got the wrong line. That's what happened. I got the wrong line. God was passing out dicks, and I said, I got the right line. I'm just playing. Ron Jeremy been killed that. Y'all give it up for back to school, man. Y'all excited about back to school? Kids going back to school? Yeah. Shit, I was happy as hell to get that nigga out of my house. I don't know what y'all talking about. I was in school shopping 2 months early. Fuck that. Shit, it got all his shit early. Had something crazy happen to him last year, kind of threw me off. He came home with a note stuck into his chest. And I know how y'all looking at me. That's what little kids, you know, kids do. They come home with a note stuck into their chest. But not when you're in the goddamn 10th grade. That hell comes home with a note stuck into your chest in the 10th fucking grade. He had to get that shit from his fucking mom. Fuck that. And the reason I know that is because when they stepped a note to my fucking chest in 10th grade, they never made it home. Not once. Not fucking once. Shit. Y'all laughing, man. Get this nigga, man. I'm ready to go get the fuck out. Shit. I swear our refrigerator door is like a fucking dog, because every time I open it, he right there. We got into the damnedest argument the other day because I was smoking a drink. Yeah, if you don't know what that means, you know, shout out to my nigga Big Drake. Right on. Hey, you meet me out for sure. Yeah, we was smoking a drink, you know what I'm saying? And I had fixed me a big dumbass Scooby-Doo sandwich. If you ain't old enough to remember Scooby-Doo and Shaggy, I was here with my shit. I work at Subway, and let's just say, sometimes the meat come up missing. I smoke pot, what y'all expect me to do? And so I'm halfway through my sandwich, and he was looking at me. Now, when little kids are little, and they say, give me some, that shit cute. But when that motherfucker 16, 17 talking about some, you gonna finish that? Yes, nigga, I am. It's mine. I fixed it because I was hungry. So we get into the damnedest debate. So I asked him, what the hell make you think I get hungry and fix you something? He had the audacity to look at me and say, you're my father. It's your job to provide. I know what y'all think. I started going old school Joe Jackson on this thing. Beat the shit. But this 2017, I decided to be a real parent. But I thought that is the thing. It is my job to fucking provide. So I went right to the store, and I got him his 18th birthday present. Lush! Brand new set with the wheels and everything. So on his 18th birthday, I'm waking his ass up at 7:59. Yeah. Get up. It's my job to provide. And I provided you with a lovely pardon gift. Godspeed, young child. Nah, man, I love my kid. I'm just joking. I love him for all 18 years. They say I got to. Yes, I do. Don't call me once you turn 8. You get the hell out. You know what I'm saying? I'm hoping he don't go to college, because then I got to go for the rest of the ride. Fuck that. I'm sorry. I know it's bad. But shifting gears, man. Man, y'all have been so much fun tonight, man. Give y'allself a round of applause. Okay. Do you want the really, really nasty stuff? Because I can get nasty.
Yeah.
Y'all want some dirty jokes? Y'all do y'all like it dirty in my hand now. I'll do it dirty up here. Okay, fuck it, we're getting dirty then. Round of applause for you to take care of me. I was like, fuck it. These guys were like, we left him downstairs. Baby, she abandoned her fucking husband. She was like, fuck his old ass. Come on, Jarvis, we're going to the comedy show without him. Fucking wouldn't give me another fucking dollar, you son of a bitch. Man, my girl take care of me because I'm a starving artist. As y'all can actually see, me in the polo wearing the same attire. I'm built exactly like it. And she take care of me, but we got in a big argument the other day. She said she gonna take back all her stuff. So I told her, take back all your stuff. Give a damn. Tell her, remember everything in her name. Goddamn house in her name, car in her name. My goddamn cell phone in her name. Speaking of that shit, I had some crazy shit happen with my cell phone. You ever dial the wrong number? You know, you don't want to talk to that person. You hang up, right, ladies?
Yeah.
2 seconds later, this fucking guy, yeah, you're not a lady. He was like, yes. No, you're not a lady. I don't know if that's what you're into, but not me, buddy. No, no. But I had some crazy shit happen, man. The guy texted me back like 2 seconds later talking about some, hey, sweetheart, how you doing today? So I text back wrong number, trying to be nice. 2 seconds later, he texts back, oh, sweetheart, you too good to talk to somebody. I said, what the fuck? So this time I got serious with his ass. I text back in all caps, wrong number, with like 3 exclamation points and that little emoji with his arms folded. They been crazy. Y'all know what I'm talking about. 2 seconds later, ladies, on behalf of all the men, I'd like to apologize to y'all because this very next thing that he sent me, I didn't know the fellas was doing this. He sent me his dick. Yes, never seen his face and seen his fucking dick. Men, if you're doing this shit, has to stop. I gave you through my new iPhone, y'all remember how much it cost. I'm like, motherfucking phones hiding giraffe pussy, shitting me. But I called him back. We got into a little back and forth, and he told me, I thought I was sending my dick to Rebecca Stevenson. I didn't have a response for that. Didn't have one at all. Thought he was sending his dick to my girlfriend. And I didn't really look at the dick, but I'm glad she didn't see it. I'm going to just say that. It's all in sight. I ain't really look. I come up with a remedy for it, though, ladies. When a guy sends you a dick that you didn't want, an unsolicited dick, you say that dick.
Look at her. No, I'm not saying
that. You say that dick. You say those dicks. And when a dude send you a dick that you don't ask him for, you send him a dick back. Yeah, fuck his whole day up. Guarantees we'll fuck her up. Damn what? I even got a name for it, ladies. Y'all ready? Good. Y'all ready? We gotta say it all together, ladies. All right. We can stop dick pics today. It's called save a dick, send a dick. Say it with me now. Save a dick.
Save a dick.
Send a dick.
Send a dick.
And if you really want to fuck him up, wait about 2 seconds after you send a dick and say, and text him and say, mine's bigger than yours. Okay, one more, then I'm gonna get out of here. Did you like me? Yeah, okay, one more, then I'm gonna get out of here. One more real quick because y'all been so much fun. We all have motivations in life, right? You know what I'm saying? Your bills motivate you to get your ass up and go to work. You know what I'm saying? Having to pay your motherfucking bills motivate you to not punch that one supervisor just a little too motherfucking over here. Yeah. If you got time to win, you got time to win. Shut up, bitch! I ain't minimum wage! Shut the fuck up! Right, just today, y'all, I ran 5 miles. Not one, not two, not three, but five. 5 whole miles. It would have been 6, but luckily the police called out the chase. Motivation! The right motivation you can do is that. Only the money, and look at my time. Chill, everything's so funny! You guys having a good time?